Rev up your engines! Here's the $500 Lexus, yes? $500. He got this 03 ES300 6 months ago, so it's not like, okay, he bought it, it's a pile of crap and it's falling apart. No, these things are really well made. Of course, it was made in Japan, and it had a lot of use, you could see. It's a seat cover here, but hey, look at the other leather seats. They're still in excellent shape. Now, if he wanted, he could reupholster the seats, but hey, a $500 car, you know, you can get nice seat covers for these things. Of course, they're solid made. You're rarely gonna find one in this kind of shape for 500 bucks, but it was through a friend. Under the hood, same as my wife's car, an ultra dependable V6 Toyota engine. And of course, it's got ABS, it's got everything you want in a car. And sure, it's got a timing belt, but this is the 3-liter, remember that. This is a non-interference engine. The next generation had an interference engine, which you don't want unless you're gonna change your timing belt every 100,000 miles. This, hey, if you don't change it and it breaks, change it. It doesn't hurt anything. If you got an interference engine, pistons hit the valves, goodbye. So you gotta be a lot more religious. And this, you don't have to. Now, I know people are always whining about plastic radiators, but check this out. This has a plastic radiator. It's still the original one, and it still works perfectly fine. And as we go inside, oh, it's only got 194,000 miles on it. Starts right up, sounds just like my wife's car. But, aha, the check engine light is on. Even though it idles like a dream, and the engine sounds great, well, I can see when a check engine light's on. He put this little adapter on, and it's too small and it ripped the hose. Well, just get the correct one to put on here. To me, this is the height of their engineering, the ZS300s. Now, originally they made the 400s because they sent a bunch of Japanese guys to California to study what do rich Americans want. And they decided it was a V8 rear wheel drive. Well, they also found that Americans later wanted better gas mileage with a car that still ran perfectly fine. And they didn't care that it wasn't rear wheel drive. This is front wheel drive. It's extremely smooth. And this, to me, was probably the best car they ever built for the money, for the drivability. You can't beat them. They're making them structurally strong so they don't have any body wave when you're taking corners. And check it out, the wheels are in better shape than my wife's because he hasn't hit any curves with them yet. And of course the trunk, there's all kinds of space in these things. The back seats have plenty of room, are super comfortable, and they're just solid built. They don't sound like that anymore. Now this guy's smart, he's got a history of buying very expensive cars used at very good prices. He mainly gets rid of them because of lifestyles. He has to get a van because he had kids, so he had to get rid of some of his other cars. He just follows it by buying used ones. Don't get suckered into the, you gotta buy new so that things will last. These things are so well made, you can get old ones. Now, odds are, you're never gonna find one of these in this kind of shape for 500 bucks, but you never know. So let's take it for a ride. They're ultra smooth riding, even this old thing. Hey, my wife's is 1 year older. Still has all four original struts on them. All four. And if you remember the video I made a while back, a Chinese company sent me new ones. I put them on and it rode like crap. So I put the old ones back on and I'm still driving on the old ones. I mean, everything on it still works. It's smooth as can be. Okay, so let's see what this thing can still do. Ah, it's peeling out. Listen to that engine. And you can't even feel the shifts. And look. The mahogany's still in good shape, even on the shifter. Okay, and I just found out his friend that he bought it from, he let his two sons drive it for years. They trashed the heck out of the thing, and it still runs like this. It does have the squeaky wheel. They all do that. Yeah. My wife does that too. Really makes me feel at home. But hey, if you can get a luxury car like this for 500 bucks, man, you just can't go wrong. And okay, I'm getting out, what do I smell? I smell a little burning oil, but the same thing with my wife's car. It needs valve cover gaskets. Now, you can buy the set for about 25 bucks and do it yourself. You do have to take the back intake off. It'd take a few hours. It's totally doable, or you can pay somebody, or you can just ignore it, because it just drips a tiny amount of oil, doesn't even make it to the ground, and just live with it. So yes, you can actually get a great luxury car for 500 bucks if you have friends who are finally tired of it. The reason he sold it was, this window stopped working. And he finally said, oh, you want to sell it to me? He says, what do you want? He says, 500 bucks. So he ran to the bank, got 500, and then just set this one up and put it in permanently because he doesn't care. If he wants to buy an actuator, fine. He could buy the whole thing. You can get him aftermarket cheap enough, but if nobody's using the back seat, who even cares? So really, age be cursed on these cars because they can last an awful long time if taken care of even remotely. At 500 bucks, you're never gonna find something like this, but if you do, get your money and run. And here's some bonus questions and answers. Well, Toyota sold almost a million vehicles in March, set an all-time record for themselves. Now everybody knows they make good cars, but part of this, of course, is the semiconductor drought. Because if you've been watching me, reading the news, Toyota planned for that. They had a supply chain so they can continue to build their vehicles. And everybody knows they're good anyways. They've got a wide choice of vehicles and the other place doesn't. And unfortunately, you know how Americans are. Take the American dealers. If they have a low supply, I've seen people looking at new cars, new American cars, then it's a low supply. So they think, oh, well, there's not many out there. We're going to charge people more money and we're going to rip them off. They'll go right across the street to the Toyota dealer then and say, look at all the choices here and they got better prices. They act like there's no competition. There's a lot of competition in the world these days. And anybody that's starting to ramp stuff up and rip it off people, they're just asking for it. I mean, it's one thing, okay, how many electric Hummers are they going to build? Not that many, so they can probably sell them all for over $100,000. That's a limited thing. But if you're talking about something like Toyota, they're selling cars and trucks to the masses, overpay for a poorly made American vehicle when you get a better choice and get a Toyota. What do you think people are going to be buying? Toyotas. They just almost sold a million vehicles in March, set an all-time record. It shows that they know what they're doing. They're smart. And they're not gouging their customers like some of the other people are saying, well, we don't have too many of these trucks, so we're going to charge a whole bunch of money for the ones we do have. Because all that these American dealerships think about is short-term gain. Again, it's the American philosophy versus the Japanese. Japanese build stuff over decades, and they plan it, and they test it. Americans are like, roll those dice, baby. Okay, here's a new car. Does it work? Let's try it out and see what happens. So it's no surprise to me that they set an all-time record in March, selling almost a million Toyotas. John Rob says, I have stiff steering. I got a late model Honda Civic. The steering feels okay at idle and driving, but when I try to reverse all the way to the right, the steering feels very heavy. It only happens when I back up. Realize you got electronic power steering. Your power boost is done through an electric motor system. Those systems, sometimes they're just not calibrated right. I would start by go to the dealer and say, is my steering calibrated right? Are there any upgrades for the software for the electronic power steering? Start there, because a lot of times there are. They just go by the VIN number of your car, they look it up, they can tell you on the phone. Give them the VIN number, are there upgrades for this power steering? If they say yes, yes. If they don't, there's nothing you can do because it's an electric system. There's no adjustments, there's no anything done on it. And if it only happens when you back up, it's only when the wheels are turning in the opposite direction and you turn it to one side, you might check your suspension system. Because it could be that something's going on like a ball joint or a tie rod, and when you back up, it goes at a certain angle and it makes the steering stiff, and it only does it when you're starting to back up. I've seen suspension problems that only occurred when you're backing up, and then later you feel it going forwards as they wear even further. But do check the suspension. See if anything's worn. Ball joints, tie rods will often wear out on Civics, and that could make it happen if it doesn't have any upgrades to the software. But check the software upgrades first. Steve's Auto Fix says, Nissan trouble. Hey, I've been working on my dad's 06 Nissan Murano whenever something needs to be fixed. Now I'm having a difficult time figuring out why there's a CVT fluid leak on the passenger side. I replaced the seal and axle, and it leaks more than it did before I worked on it. It's front wheel drive. And did I mention I hate Nissan? Yes, well, it is your father's car. Try to help him out. Your father wasn't that intelligent when he bought the car. Obviously, you don't own one. Now, you change the seal and the axle. They can leak from various places. So watch my video, How to Find Engine Oil Leaks. It also works on transmission. You get a little ultraviolet leak dye in a little kit with ultraviolet light. Put it in, you can see exactly where that green dye and yellow dye, when you wear the sunglasses and UV light, you see where it's coming from. Now, it could come from various places. Those CVT transmissions are very complex. They split apart, they got gaskets all over the place. So make sure you see where it's coming from. But if it's coming from the axle seal there that you replaced, then either you got got a bad part, either the shaft itself fits in or the seal isn't right, or if it's worn inside, if it's worn inside the transmission, it's going to wobble. And if it has enough wobble, even though you got a new seal and a new shaft, it's wobbling because the shaft is put into the transmission. The transmission's wobbling, it'll wobble, and of course, it will leak out of the seal. And yes, they are that poorly made that they can do that. Now, the reason I say don't buy Nissans, especially that particular vehicle, it's one of the worst they ever made as they age. The CVTs are bad enough. Whole car isn't that great, but as you find out, put the leak dye in. Pray it's something else like a gasket higher up and it's dripping down. Put that dye in, you can find where the leak is. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.